All right. Welcome, welcome. Happy Tuesday, everybody. Welcome to your upper body conditioning workouts. We have Jill and Jay, my family, here with me today. All right, they're going to join us for our workout. So you're going to watch them for warm-up ideas, or at home, you do whatever you want to do for your upper body. So I suggest, at the very least, big arm circles, both directions, shoulder rolls, both directions, some neck rolls over here like Jay, at the very least. But they will give you some lot of ideas. So we'll talk about the 8 exercises we have today. You're going to watch, practice if you want to, and then we'll get started afterwards. So today we got the first pair I'm going to talk about. First exercise is a reverse fly. So you're going to sit back, so the torso is parallel. We have a wall option today as well if you need to. The weights are going to be together here. Your arms are slightly bent. Sitting back, squeeze them up, bring them down with control, squeeze them up, bring them down with control. So in the front, it's going to look like you're basically sitting back, torso is down, your belly's in your lap here. You're doing like a hug. So the motion here is like a hug, like you're hugging a big column. You're sitting back, hugging, reverse fly. You're gonna squeeze out, feel in the back of the shoulder back here. Squeeze, bring it down. That is number one, all right? Number two, we got a power push-up, an exercise I invented, or at least I haven't seen anyone else do it, so I'm gonna say that I invented it. So we have a little low squat position here. You're going to have your arms out here. You're gonna fall forward and catch yourself and then push yourself back. So you're gonna fall forward, lean forward, catch yourself, push yourself back. Lean forward, catch yourself, push yourself back, right? Now when you get too tired of that, you can walk your hands out. Walk them out, do your push-up here, either on your knees or on your toes, push-up. You can do a push-up release where you come down all the way, then push yourself back up, so, and then you come back. All right, so you have those two options. You can walk out, or you can fall, catch, push back, all right? That's the first pair. Pair number two. Grab our weights again. We're gonna have a seat. So you set them up, here's how you lie down with your weights. You put them next to you, you sit down in between them, like that. You place them here onto your legs, and then you lie back with them. That's how we set up. All right, so now you're lying back with your weights. Your shoulder blades squeeze back together. Just like that first exercise we did, our elbows will be slightly bent. We're gonna open out, feel that stretch in the chest, and then we're going to squeeze them up. So just like that first one we did, you're basically doing a hugging motion. So I took them out with my arms, it's a big hugging motion. Feel that stretch, then squeeze them together. Dumbbells come together, squeeze, stretch, squeeze, all right? That is number three. Basically the opposite of that first one we did. First one we were going backwards, this one we're going forwards, all right? Number two, place them to the sides here. Got another push-up exercise here. So a couple options. You're down here on your forearms. You're going to use your legs to help you walk up to a push-up position here, and then you do a couple mountain climbers, then you go back down like that, all right? Go back up, walk up, use your feet to help you if you need to, a couple mountain climbers, and then come back down like that. Now, you can also be up here, come down by just stepping your hands down, up and down. When you come back up, do your mountain climbers, and then go back down like that, all right? That is the second exercise of the second pair. All right, third pair. We'll start off with just some good old bicep curls. Now, if you have heavy weights, you can do your bicep curls, take a little break as you need to. All right, if you have some lighter weights, you can add a pause at halfway. Come up, add a pause at halfway. So it depends how heavy your weights are, folks. But just some good old fashioned bicep curls, nothing crazy with that. The next exercise after that, we have another push-up and another row here. So, in a push-up position here. So now notice my feet are a good distance apart here. My hands good distance apart. That way I have good balance here. I'm going to one arm at a time, do my row, bring it up, and then throw in a push-up at the bottom there, okay? Now a couple options with this. Now you don't have to use both at the same time. You can just use one. You're here, doing your row, roll over to the other side, do your row, get it out of the way, and then you do your push-up. And of course, your push-up can be on your knees, can be on your toes, it can be a push-up with a release, up to you. Make sure either option, your shoulder is stacked over your hands here. So I'm not doing my push-up back here, I'm not like this. I'm leaning forward, I'm going back, elbows over the wrists, stacked perpendicular, come down, come up. All right, that is number six. Number seven, final pair, we start with curl and then an overhead press. So you're gonna curl the weight up and press straight up, bring it down with control, then back down. Now, if the overhead press starts to get heavy, you can do more curls. So instead of a 1-to-1 ratio, you can do two or three curls. 1, 2, maybe a third curl, and then do a press. So you can change up the ratio if you need to, depending on which one you need to, right? That is the first one. Second one, we're down, no more push-ups, but we have a bear crawl. So, with our dumbbells, let me show you from the side first. We're here. Now you can either just hold this position, that's perfectly fine. If you want to add more of a challenge to it, then one arm and one leg is going to move forward, and then the other one's going to move forward. You're just going to crawl, you're going to stay low, both knees are going to stay close to the floor, and you'll crawl forward as far as you want, and then go back, right? So notice my opposite arm, opposite leg is moving. Right arm, left leg, left arm, right leg, all right? That is your final exercise. All right, you just got a little phone call. All right, folks, so we just practiced all 8. I will remind you again of them all, so don't you worry. Right now, here we're gonna do about 15 jumping jacks. 15 jumping jacks and about 5 inchworms. So 15 jumping jacks here, 15 jumping jacks at home, and 5 inchworms. So walk it out, and then walk it back. All right, 5 inchworms after your 15 jumping jacks. Then we'll get started. I'll remind you of all the exercises again, don't worry. At first, pair, your lead sitting back, fly up like that, that reverse hug, and then the power push-up, all right? We've got each pair, we're gonna do twice before we move on to the next pair. Within each pair, it's only a 5-second break within the exercises. So basically, as soon as you finish an exercise today, expect to go right into that next one. Basically, that's what it is, right? So when you finish, 5 seconds, it's just enough time for you to put your weights down or pick them up and go right into that next one, okay? We get a longer break in between the pairs, and I'll tell you when that is. But basically, expect just go right into that next one when you finish, okay? No breaks today, basically. All right, so they did their 15 jumping jacks at home, 15 jumping jacks, and then their 5 inchworms, walk it out, walk it back. All right, 30 seconds each time we do an exercise. We do each pair twice. We'll start with that reverse fly. Jill will show you the wall version for some back support. Big hug here. Okay, folks, here we go. Let's take a look. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's take a look. So I'm sitting back, like I have a wall behind me. I'm squeezing up, slow down, squeeze up, slow down, squeeze up, slow down, all right? From the front, you can see it's like a big hug. My arms are slightly bent, like a big circle here at the bottom. Squeeze. Come down, squeeze, come out. Now watch me. You don't have to come up super high. Watch how high I come up. It's not that high. See, it's not that high. Look at my dumbbells. They're not going up that high. Right? You go up just right here where you can't squeeze up any higher. And time. All right. Power push-up now. Power push-up. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Lean forward, hands down. Push back. Lean forward, hands down. Push back. Either do that one or you walk forward, walk back. All right? Walk forward, walk back. Got a couple options. All right, let's take a look. Good. Excellent. He's doing the harder version. He squats down, he leans forward, he falls forward, he catches himself, he pushes back. Excellent. Over here, she's also doing the hard version. Here we go. We got 12 seconds left, folks. As they get tired, they can walk it out if they need to. Walk it out, and then walk it back. Walk it out, do that push-up if you can. If not, walk it out, walk it back. 3, 2, 1. All right, back to number one, back to the reverse fly, back to number one, back to the first exercise. Here we go. Back to the first exercise. Sit back. Squeeze, bring it down slow. Squeeze. Now make sure you're sitting back. Sit back. The reason why we sit back is because we want our torso parallel to the floor, right? So that we can work up against gravity. Gravity pushes down, we have to push up against gravity. If we're upright, we're pushing back here, but gravity's pushing down. That doesn't work, all right? 9 seconds. Torso is parallel, push back here. Push up. Hips back, sit down. We've got 3, 2, 1. And time. All right, folks, power push-up. Good. Okay, 1, 2 strokes from the side. Yeah. All right, folks, here we go. Power push-up. Let's take a look. Good. Fantastic. Falls forward, catches yourself, pushes back. Staying in that low squat position here. Catch and push back. You have to use that power to push back. Bend your elbows like a push-up and push back. Here we go. 15 seconds. Now, you can also remember, you can just walk it out if you need to. Walk. Do a push-up here if you want to or not. Walk it back. Stay low, and then walk it forward, walk it back. We've got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. Fantastic, all right. That was the first pair. Now we move into the second pair. We get a quick little 25 second break now. Sit back. Remember, we had the dumbbells, we sit in between them, we lie back. So we put them on our legs, then we lie back. We have the chest fly, so just like the reverse fly, but the chest fly, right? Squeeze and stretch. Okay, folks, so we're getting into position. Here we go. We're starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's begin. So just like that first exercise, arms are slightly bent. You can see here from the front here, you can see his arms are slightly bent. This looks like he's just giving a hug. If he didn't have dumbbells in his hand, he would just be giving a hug. That's all it is. You feel that stretch as you go out in the chest, you squeeze it up, squeeze it together. Excellent. Got 10 seconds left. From the side, you can see your dumbbells still stay at chest level. So they don't drift down, they don't drift up. They stay right there, chest level. We got 3, 2, 1, and timer. We got the push-up next, folks. Here we go. Push-up position. Walk back to a mountain climber. Walk back up to that mountain climber, right? Walk down into that plank. Walk up into the mountain climber. Walk down and walk back up. So your mountain climber is lean forward, hips down. You can walk onto your forearms, or you can just step them down. Step them down, step them back up. So yeah, a couple options, right? Good. So yeah, there's two options here, you can see. See, mountain climbers, and then she's gonna step them down, and then she's gonna bring them back up, step them back up, right? The other option over here, mountain climbers and time, all right, good. All right, back to that first exercise. Back to the chest fly, chest fly, chest fly. Here we go. Here, open out, squeeze together. Open out, squeeze together. Take your time with this one, folks. Don't rush. It's only 30 seconds, but don't rush, all right? Take your time for the stretch and squeeze it together. Good. 10 seconds. All right. Okay, get ready for that push-up in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. All right, dumbbells to the side, folks. Let's show them those options again. Let's see. 3, 2, 1. Let's take a look. All right, so as I was saying before, see, he's walking back. His forearms are down like a plank. He walks back up. Does his mountain climbers. Now, if you want to, you don't have to walk. That makes it a little bit tougher. You can just go down and up. Like that, right? If you need to, walk. Here we go, folks. You got 15 seconds, so give me a few more. You got the mountain climbers, hips are down. She's leaning forward. That's excellent. Leaning forward. Goes down, steps down, steps down. Takes your time. Comes back up. Those are mountain climbers. You got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. One time. Fantastic. All right, go ahead and stand back up. That was pair number 2. Pair number 3, we got curls. Just little bicep curls, okay? And then we have the Renegade Row with the push-ups afterwards, all right? Let's take a look. You watch them for the curls, I'll start showing you the next one as an early reminder, all right? Here we go, 13 seconds, bicep curls. At home, your weight's a little light, add a pause at halfway. Here, we got heavy weights, you just do your regular bicep curls, all right? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's begin. All right. Let's take a look. So we got regular bicep curls here. Now, if they want to, they can also add a pause at halfway. That's fine too, right? Pause at halfway, that's fine. Okay, we got 20 seconds left. I'm gonna take this opportunity to show you the next exercise because at home you're probably standing, you're probably watching the TV. So let me show you the next one while you're, well, the next 14 seconds you go down. All right, so this is the next one. Row, and then you push up. All right, you can also do just one dumbbell. We got 3, 2, 1, and time. All right. Back down, here we go. Row and then the push-up. 3, 2, 1, let's begin. Now the one dumbbell version here. Row, roll it over to the other side, do the row, and then drop down into your push-up. The push-up can be on your knees too, folks. You can do the whole exercise on your knees as well. You can do the entire thing on your knees as well. All right, 14 seconds. Row, one arm, hold on. Good. 7 seconds. Here we go. Watch this, folks. Watch this. Just push up. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. And time. Let's stand back up for the curls, folks. For the curls. Back up. Back up. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Back to the curls. All right. Do your curls. Good. Fantastic. Yeah, a little pause. Give me a little pause halfway. Show me a couple pauses halfway. Halfway pause. And then continue. Good. Do a couple pauses. All right. Let me show you that second one again. I'll talk about it again because right now you're probably just standing there. It's a good time for me to talk to you. So, again, the one dumbbell version here. Got 10 seconds left. Do your row, roll it to the other side, do your row, and then do your push-up. On your knees is fine too. 3, 2, and 1. All right, second exercise. Back down, folks, back down. Row to the push-up, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Good, let's take a look. Good. Doing a push-up, yep. Good, she's going all the way down. She got the push-up release here, all the way down. She releases, comes up. Take a look at her row there. She goes to her hips. She brings it to her hips. So not up to the chest, not up to the armpit. Back to the hips there. The waistband. Bring it up. Good. Excellent, excellent. We got 10 seconds left. Take a look at their hips as they're going. They're not twisting and turning too much. They're staying stable. Their feet are wide for support. They're not twisting and turning. We got 3. We have 2. And 1. And time. Fantastic. All right. Very good. That was pair number 3. We've got pair number 4. With the curl and press. All right, the curl press, up and down, that's all it is, and then the dumbbell bear crawl. I'll show you that one as well as we're doing the first one. All right, folks, curl and press. Curl and press. Remember, if the press gets a little hard, you can do more curls and fewer presses, so you can change the ratio. You can maybe 3-1, all right? Let's get to ready. All right, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's begin. All right, let's take a look. I'll talk a little bit, then I'll show you the next one. I just did wrong. So we got the press, the curl, good. Take a look at this. See, she's going, she's got control. Her core is raised, she's not arching back. When she presses up, she's not leaning back. She's staying tall, Good, a nice wide stance like a squat. About 15 seconds. All right, at home, you're doing this, you're probably standing watching the TV. I'm gonna show you the next one, so you can be prepared for it. We got now 10 seconds left. One, then one arm, one leg. Same time, knees close to the floor. Here we go. All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, time. All right, folks, down. Here we go. All right, here we go. One limb, one arm. Those are the same time. One leg, one arm. Right knee, left. Sorry, right knee, left arm. Left knee, right arm. Opposite. Move forward, stay low. Move forward as far as you want. Then come back. Keep going. Now, again, if you need to hang out here, just hold right here too. Hold right here. That's fine. Hold right here. It's an option too, folks. We've got 8 seconds left. All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, back up, curl and press. Curl and press, back up. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. Curl and press. Let's take a look. Curl and press. Now again, if they're getting tired of the press, they can do more curls and fewer presses, all right? Again, I'll remind you that second one. You can hold it here, you can move if you want. So, right and left, move. Left and right, move. Keep it low, keep those knees close to the floor. Right, that is the next one, right? We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. All right, back down, back to that exercise I just showed you. Back down. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Knees down, knees close to the floor, the core is engaged, bend those knees close down. Move slowly, you don't have to move a whole lot. 10 seconds left, folks, keep going. You can just hang out right here, just hold this right here if you need to. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. Fantastic. All right, folks, stay right there. That was the first half. Take a little break, we shake it out, folks. Shake it out, take a little break. A little bit of water here. All right. A little bit of water, we are going to repeat everything we just did once again. We're halfway done with the workout. All right. Take a little break here. Shake it out, do a couple of little shoulder rolls. All right, that first half, now it goes fast. These Tuesday and Wednesday, we go pretty fast here, all right? That's why we can have fairly heavy weights. We can use some stronger exercises so that we go pretty fast to keep the heart rate up, to keep the conditioning up. So that first half, it's okay if you're a little shaky. Now we can get into it. The second half, same exercises, same amount. We've done each one already twice. So now we can really get it. All right, so right now, do a couple of stretches, a little bit of water. Nice long break here. Start back over that beginning, that first exercise. Reverse fly. Sitting back, torso is down. See, it's parallel down here. Squeeze up like a hook. All right, and then we have the power push-up. All right, we'll take about another minute here. Another minute. Really relax. Really shake out the arms here. Now, a lot of these exercises have push-ups in them. If you need to do fewer push-ups, you can also just skip the push-up. You can do that push-up release if you want to. That push-up release, remember, is when you go all the way down. All the way down, you can lift your arms up, you relax for a moment, then you push yourself back up. Alright, so that push and release is there to help you as well. Alright, folks. Alright, so set up your weights, get ready for that reverse fly, and then into that power push up afterwards. Alright, get ready. Here we go, folks. Here we go. Let's get ready, folks. Round two. Here we go. Let's begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's take a look. So we're sitting back. Squeeze up, bring it down. Squeeze up, bring it down. Nice and slow and controlled. Let's take a look. Good. So you're sitting back. You're using the wall for support. Good. Trying to get that torso parallel. Squeeze it back, all right? Keep going. We got 15 seconds. All right, 13 seconds, folks. Squeeze it up. Bring it down nice and slow. We got 9 seconds left. Give me a couple more. At home, couple more. 5 seconds. Give me two more. Squeeze it up. Give me one more. Fantastic. All right, dumbbells down. Give me the power push-up. Squat position. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Fall forward. Catch yourself. Push back. All right, or walk it out. Walk it out if you need to. Walk it out. Walk it back. All right, do that push-up when you walk out if you want to. If your arms are tight, you can't do the push-ups, you don't have to do the push-ups. Just walk it out. Walk it back in. All right. Only 30 seconds, so don't stop, folks. Only got 15 seconds left now. Yep. Slow push back. Good. They're keeping going, but anytime they need to, they'll just walk out, walk back. We got 9 seconds left. Keep it going. Then we'll go back to the reverse fly. So get ready to stand back up in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. All right, go ahead, stand back up. Stand back up, sit back. Use the wall if you need to, folks, for that back support. Sit back, reverse fly. Squeeze, bring it down slow, squeeze, bring it down slow. Lead with the upper arm. Squeeze it up, bring it back down slow. Sit back. 10 seconds left, folks. Give me a few more. Here we go. 8 seconds. Squeeze it up. Really good. Here we go. 5, 4, 3. Give me one more. All right, folks. And down to the power push-up. Here we go. Last one. Here we go. Push. Explode back. All right. Good. Make sure you walk out version again as well. Here you walk it out. Do that push-up if you want to. If you can, then walk it back. Alright? Here we go. Halfway, folks, halfway. Good. Keep going. Push back. Explode back. Good. Explode. Here we go. 7 seconds. Give me two more. Good. One more. Finish that. Push back. And time. Good. All right, folks, shake it out. That was pair number 1. We don't have to see that again. Pair number 2, we got the floor fly. So dumbbell sides here. It's that first exercise, but we're all lying on our back this time doing the hug. So the first one, we're leaning forward doing the hug. Now we're lying down doing the hug, okay? Then after that, we have that push-up. That push-up to that mountain climber. All right, folks, here we go. 10 seconds. Get ready. Just fly, take a look. Here, I'll show you the back version as well. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So you can see from the front view, my arms are slightly bent. I open out, I feel that stretch in the chest, then I squeeze it together. I stretch open here, stretch, take it slow, and squeeze together. Stretch, take it slow, squeeze together. Alright. Keep those shoulder blades, squeeze and roll back. Here we go, 9 seconds left. Here we go, give me a couple more. In 5 seconds, you'll put them down, you'll go into your push-up to mountain climber. In 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, put them to the side. Push up, mountain climber. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. All right. Use your legs here. Walk them back. Walk them forward. Do that mountain climber. Walk them back. Walk them forward. Do that mountain climber. Or you can step your arms down. Step. All right, step. Do the mountain climber. Good. 10 seconds. If you need to, just hang out there and just do the mountain climbers. Here we go. 7 seconds. 5, 4, get ready to lie back down in 3, 2, 1. All right, lie back down on your back here, dumbbells in hands. The hugs, hugging time. It's a lot more fun if I call them hugs than chest-wise. All right, so stretch. Good, you can see from the side again, dumbbells are right there at chest level, so they don't drift down belly level, they don't drift up to head level, they stay right there, chest level. All right, you can see over here, elbows are slightly bent, so we got 12, 10 seconds left. Up just a little bit, he's stretching the chest and he's squeezing it together. He goes down slow, he stretches, and then he squeezes it together for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. Put your dumbbells down, mountain climber to push-ups. Here we go. Mountain push-up, here we go. Go back, and then come up and do your mountain climbers. All right, or just hang out here and just do your mountain climbers here. All right, make sure you're leaning forward. Take a look. I'm leaning forward here at the top. Shoulders are over the hands, good. Good. In the step version here, come down. taking her time to come up. She's not twisting and turning too much. She's bracing the core. She's trying to fight it. We got 10 seconds left, folks. Keep it going. Keep it going. Here we go, folks. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. Fantastic, folks. Go ahead, stand back up. All right, that was pair number 2. We are 3/4 of the way done. We have curls next, and then we have the row to the push-up, all right? So put your dumbbells in your hands, get yourself ready, and get a little bit of a break here. We've got 15 seconds left now. A little water now if you want. Got those bicep curls. Bicep curls, again, I'll show you what the next exercise looks like as you're doing the bicep curls, just for better time management, for multitasking. All right, here we go. Bicep curls in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a look. So we got bicep curls. I'm crazy here. Go slow at home. If you got lighter weights, add a pause at halfway. Here, they're gonna still add a pause halfway until they get too tired. Then they'll just go up and down, right? Standing up tall. All right. You're probably watching the TV right now, so I'll take this chance to show you the next one as a reminder, just in case you forgot. All right. Got 10 seconds left. I'll show you a couple reps here. I'll show you on my knees too. All right. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. All right, folks, and then let's go down here. Let's go down. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, let's begin. I'll show you the knee version here. Push up. Do your row. Good. Even on your knees, your knees are wide here for the balance. Do your push up. Do that row. Your feet are wide, folks. Feet are wide. Do your row. Good. Got 12 seconds. Good. Good. He's going all the way down for that push up. She comes back up. Take a look at this row, folks. He goes back to the hips. Excellent. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, back up to the curls, folks. Back up to the curls. Back to the curls. Here we go. Here we go. Curls. Curls, curls, curls. Nice up curls. Let's take a look. Good. He's had a little pause. It's excellent. As he gets tired, he can get rid of the pause. But he's feeling good now, so he adds that pause. All right, so last time we're doing this exercise. So throw in a couple pauses if you can. We only got 18 seconds left. Keep going, keep going. Keep going, here we go. We got 14 seconds left. Good, good, good. Standing up tall. Just slightly bent with the knees. Standing up tall. Don't arch back as we come up. Torso up tall. Wrist the core. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time. All right, back down, folks. Back down, back down. Here we go. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's take a look. Now, you can also just use one dumbbell for this. One dumbbell and just roll it over to the other side. All right? So you got one dumbbell in hand. Do your row. Roll it to the other side. And then do your row on the other side. And then do your push-up. And you can just stay on your knees there the whole time. All right, so you can stay on your knees the whole time. Any time to go down. Good, good, good. Row. He's switching arms here. Switching arms. He puts it down there. He does his push-up. Comes back up. Here we go. And time. Fantastic job, folks. Here we go. That was pair number 3. Go ahead and stand back up. We're going to start pair number 4 in 24 seconds. All right, the final pair here, folks. The final pair. We have those curl to press, and then the bear crawl on the floor, okay? And I might show you that one again as we're doing that first exercise. All right, folks. Ready, ready, ready? All right, 10 seconds, folks. Here we go. Curl and press, curl and press, all right? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Do that curl, press it straight up. Bring it down with control. Now, if you need to do more curls and fewer presses, you can do 3 to 1, all right? Good. Standing up tall, we're not arching back, not leaning back. Keep going, keep going. We got another 17 seconds, all right? 15 seconds. I'm gonna start doing the next one just so you can see, because right now, hopefully you're in a good position to watch me, and then we'll get started. I'll tell you what, we've got 10 seconds left of this. Three, two, one, and time. All right, folks, put them down, get into position with me. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, let's begin. Here we go. 14 seconds, folks. You can also just hold it there. Just like this, just like Jay here, just hanging out here and hold it here. 8 seconds left. Good. Walking. Good. Good. There we go. Nice. Nice and controlled. 3, 2, 1. All right. Stand back up, folks. This is it. This is it. Final time through. Curl press. Here we go. Curl press. Here we go. Here we go. Curl press. Let's go. Let's go. Now, maybe you got one heavy dumbbell at home. You can, of course, do it with one hand or with one dumbbell. Curl and press. All right. And maybe your dumbbell is really heavy. You can do more curls, 3, 4, 5 curls, and then a press. All right. The curl might be a little bit stronger for you than the press. So do more curls. Got 13 seconds.
Here we go. Curl and press.
Good. Take your time. Core up. Core brace. Torso up. Nice and rigid. Don't arch back. Don't lean back. Stand up tall. Lean forward. Stand up tall. Tall. 3, 2, 1. Time. All right, folks. Back down. Final exercise. Here we go. Back down. Back down. Let's go. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Here we go. At the very least, hold it there. Don't move. At the very least, hold it there. All right, don't drop down. Those knees are not going to touch the floor. They're close to the floor, but they're not touching. Good, good, good. Get out of the way. Good. Got 15 seconds left, folks. This is it. This is it. This is it. Let's go. Good, good. Get the core braced. Knees down as close to the floor as you can. Get those knees down. We got 7 seconds left, folks. Here we go. Here we go. Keep going. Keep going. 3, 2, 1, and time. Fantastic job, folks. Fantastic job. It is hot here. We're sweating at home. Hopefully you got some AC on. You're not sweating like us, but great job for doing this. Jill? Jay? My father and daughter? Excellent job, you two. At home, excellent job. Tuesday's upper body conditioning day. A little bit lighter weights. We coming off from yesterday where the weights were the heaviest of the week. Today, the weights are the lightest of the week of all the days we use weights. So the exercises, a little bit more complex than yesterday. Yesterday was pretty simple. A little bit more to this, a lot of push-ups. But hopefully we're giving you a lot of options. You can, of course, if you can't do push-ups, you can modify them. Push up on your knees, push up release. Skip the push-up, a lot of options there. A lot of stuff we do today as well, you can just hold the position as well. So hopefully you followed along. Thank you. Happy Tuesday. Enjoy the rest of your day. Stay cool, folks. It's hot today. It's hot all week. So stay cool, stay hydrated. Take care.